Akira Toriyama. Fucking Piccolo. Some no-namers.
Is this a Gohan and Piccolo movie?
It better be. Damn, do you see that booty shot right there from that note?
Oh, yeah. Bulma's still packing the heat.
Is that Mr. Satan's retarded cousin? What the fuck is that?
Oh, great.
Oh, my God.
Gohan 7th attempt at a redemption. Oh,
this is supposed to be a Gohan redemption story?
Oh, shit. Did you see that? That was fat Gotenks.
Yeah. I thought it was Yajirobe. Oh, it is fat Gotenks.
Yes. There's Whis, Beerus. Okay. This is definitely super. A lot of Piccolo. That little kid looks like an Adams Family member or something.
Gohan, listen closely. You have the potential to become the most powerful being on Earth.
I forgot you Piccolo's voice in English.
Not this shit again. Oh my God, Piccolo, you know he's fucking useless.
To draw out all your strength and use it to protect your world and everyone in it.
Is this like Mystic 2 is what I think
so,
I just saw?
Superhero, I mean... Let's be real here, guys. Why didn't we just get a great Saiyaman game? It would have been way cooler. I mean, Cucked Gohan is the least cool form of his character. Let's put ratings to Gohan. Number one, Cell Saga Super Saiyan 2 Trunks, right?
Yeah.
Top. Right below him, probably Kid Gohan that went apeshit when he looked at the moon. In the early, I mean, what I don't even know what saga you call that. Like, what was that?
That was
Raditz saga.
That was like the Saiyan saga. I think they call that the
Saiyan. Okay, yeah. So the Saiyan saga. You know, I think I put that at number two. Number three, just because of the radical haircut, bowl cut Gohan from Namek saga with the Saiyan armor on, radical look, dope look. I'm gonna give him points just for the style. Okay. Number four, we'll go Mystic Gohan. Almost we'll call Peak Potential Gohan, where he had the most promise. Something Piccolo mentioned in this trailer.
He's mentioned it a few times in history.
And then five, we get Great Saiyan Man. And then all the way at the bottom, we got Cucked Adult Gohan.
This is, he's definitely getting a new level of Mystic Gohan. At the end of that trailer, the way it showed his Kai, it was that, like, glossy white Kai from the Mystic Gohan form. But it looked a little different, so I think it's, like, getting an upgrade. But my immediate criticism of this is, where the fuck's Vegeta?
Well, this whole game is lynching on the idea that Goku and Vegeta aren't there.
Well, this is a movie, right? Is this a game or a movie?
It's a game.
Are you sure? I thought this was a movie. They didn't show any gameplay. Like, it was just all...
You're right.
I think this is a movie, man.
I thought because this dumbass CGI they do nowadays, I thought some of it was gameplay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It is that CG. I was thinking it looked hand-drawn, some of it, but I think they've just gotten so good at CG that they almost looks hand-drawn at this point.
Hey, it's just some of the moments where, like, Piccolo's falling out of the sky, like, into the clouds, and, like, the charge-up moments. Like, it just looks like the intros to fighting scenes and stuff like that in video games. Doesn't really look like a...
Looks like DBFC.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. This, I'm not too excited about this. I'm so down on Gohan at this point. Gohan just, like, he peaked when he was 12, and that was, like, fucking when I was 12.
I think the next thing to look forward to with Dragon Ball's IP is when Akira Toriyama's son takes over. Because he'll be fresh blood, and he's already getting put in the position to take it all over. So I'm hoping he brings some cool ideas to the table. You know, I want to see, like, it's really a shame that they never messed around with, you know, more alternate universes like GT and, you know, still to this day, the fact that they've never done a love note to Dragon Ball AF, You know, every super Dragon Ball fan out there knows what Dragon Ball AF is.
Such a deep cut, though. If you it's like you're like,
but everybody that's into Dragon Ball knows. They know, and it's just like the fact that there's never been a love note to like all those ludicrous Super Saiyan levels that everyone always dreamt about when they were little teenagers, dude. It's little stuff like that. The fact that, you know, like we never got a continuation of like GT with the Black Star Dragon Balls or even like a little nod to it or anything like that. It's just,
and Akira Toriyama, from what I've heard, has kind of come to Jesus with GT. Like, he doesn't like resent it like he used to. And I think that, I don't think it's canon or anything, but like, I don't think he like is like really against it like he used to be. GT just had some really cool stuff in it. Like Baby Vegeta, you mentioned, like the Vegeta, and also it's GT ended with Vegeta being the strongest, which is unprecedented for Dragon Ball Z. Like, he'll be the strongest at certain points, but the saga will always end with Goku being stronger.
Yeah.
Not in GT. GT ended with Vegeta being the superior Saiyan, which is one of the reasons it has a special place in my heart. Also, the mustache. Like, we need to bring back the fucking mustache.
Dude, it was strong, dude.
It was.
It's just, I feel like I didn't really enjoy Super as much as a lot of other fans. I thought it was a cool, you know, I was glad to see it continue, but at the same time, it kind of showed me that it's really a kind of a worn out idea at this point, you know. And
well, just took the Budokai and put it on a cosmic level. It's the same arc, but on a different scale. Like,
exactly.
There's nowhere to go past that either. Like, I've always been wondering. I know the manga kept going, and I know Super's going to come back eventually. And I've always kind of wondered to myself, how do you go past a cosmic Budokai, like universal level Budokai? Like, there's nothing above that, right? Like, how are they going to top that?
D-Power. Well, you know, and you look at this movie, it's kind of a natural direction. I mean, this is kind of what I was talking about. They're kind of filling in. If that's Mystic Gohan level 2 in this movie, then they're kind of filling in a hole a little bit, you know, like I was just bitching about. Like, there, it seems like maybe that might be their next move, to go back and maybe connect GT, maybe make Gohan not such a bitch character, you know, fill in some bad holes.
Yep. Well, I'll say positives. Seeing fat Gotenks again is really awesome.
That is good.
Like, that was one
thing. Brings me back to the Buu saga.
Yeah, the one thing that's really underrated about the Buu saga is the comedy in it. It had some of, like, the most top-notch comedy Dragon Ball's ever seen. And
well, he's also a really cool character.
Yeah, fat Gotenks was a shit. Old man Gotenks was kind of funny, too. But
just Gotenks in general was a really cool character.
I'm sure like adults that watched it back in the day didn't like him as much, but because we were kids when that came out, I think it hit us differently, probably. That's my guess. But yeah, I don't know how I feel about a Gohan and Piccolo movie. Like, I love Piccolo. I used to love Gohan, but it's just like, think about the last movie. The last movie was the Super Broly movie. That was like one of the most intense anime movies of all time. It was so epic. And now they're like, it feels like they're taking two steps backward. And it's like, now Piccolo's going to fuck around with adult Gohan and they're going to play superhero and maybe the great Saiyan Man will show up. It's like, fuck. I don't know.
I mean, if it's well done, it's well done. It'll be good, but
true that.
Yeah. I don't really see how that movie can really compare energy-wise to a Broly movie.
Yeah. Well, it is directed, animated, and written by Akira Toriyama. I don't know if you noticed that at the very beginning of the trailer.
Yeah. Oh,
so, yeah, like, this is a full-on OG production. So that gives me some hope, at least. It hasn't been outsourced. It's not like the interns doing their own movie or something.
Might be his last hurrah.
Do you think this movie is going to usher in the next Dragon Ball Super season? Do you think it's going to come out like right after this movie?
Probably something like that. It's been a while since Super's been on air, so.
Yeah.
Well, it's been like a year almost.
Two, I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think 2020 is when it ended. maybe even earlier. It might have been 2019. Honestly, it was definitely 2 years ago at least. All right, so final question before we wrap this up. Are you intrigued enough by this? You're going to go watch it in the theater, or are you just going to wait for VOD?
I mean, come on, man. I'm not going to go watch this shit in the theater, dude.
Yeah, if you can't, it's so funny. Like, me and you are as super fan as it gets of Dragon Ball in terms of Western audiences. Like, we grew up with it. Like,
I would say
to
that.
The umpteenth degree. You don't think so?
I mean, we're fans, no doubt about it, but you roll into some Comic-Cons.
Well, we're not nut jobs,
true. Whoa, dude, whoa. Don't alienate
anybody. We don't cosplay and, like, you know, role play in bed with our wives. Like, I want you to dress up as Bulma. What? You heard me.
There's people that name their kids Son Goku, you know? There's people right. that fucking okay.
True.
Get tattoos I take of the it Dragon back. Ball franchise on their skin. I'm not there. I'm not doing that.
Yeah.
I don't buy t-shirts that have, you know, the orange gi logo t-shirts from Hot Topic or Spencer's. I don't do that shit.
All right. Well, I own 5 Vegeta shirts, and Vegeta is my favorite anime character of all time. So maybe I'm a little bit more of a DBZ fan than you are. Maybe that's what we're discovering right now.
See, you have a wife and kids. You've already done it. You don't need to worry about your public image, dude. You're rolling outside with your fucking weathered anime Vegeta t-shirt.
Bro, have you seen my Meijin Vegeta shirt? It's like one of the sickest shirts that exists. Is fucking badass.
It's one of the, see, that's the genuine remarks of a married man that doesn't give a fuck. He's like, I've seen my Vegeta shirt, dude. It is sick as fuck, dude. I would be like, I don't have a Vegeta shirt. What are you talking about? It's like, I've never seen that shirt in my life. I don't know who it belongs to.